Hi, welcome to ESP32 tutorial from Robojax. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how we can send the stepper motor from the interface of your phone or mobile device or a browser to any predetermined angles by simple touch. It will be controlled over Wi-Fi and you will have unlimited number of push buttons. Each will have their own angle, direction, and speed. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. A stepper motor is widely used in many applications in mechatronics, automation, and other industrial applications. And I've spent quite some time working with stepper motor, DC motor, Arduino, and other means to control it, including direct connection or over Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. And I've written this code for this motor so you can control and send the stepper motor to any desired angle. You just press a push button and the motor will go to that angle. If you're using Arduino, I have separate video for this where you can set the angle, where you can set the direction, and you can set the speed for each push button. And there are no limits. As long as your device will allow you to have more push buttons, you can have and you can send it to that angle. Now, in this tutorial, you will be able to control the stepper motor with unlimited number of push buttons over the Wi-Fi, either from your phone or your computer or tablet browser. So you will have different push buttons, each have separate angle, direction, and speed. Just touch it and the motor will go to that angle and with that speed and direction. Also, you can have custom angle with different direction and speed. You can type it directly on the screen and just send and the motor will go to that direction. And this is available for ESP32 and ESP8266, D1 mini and node MCU. Now let me explain the wiring. I've connected 5 volts, external 5 volts to this module. Make sure that we have this jumper, it is connected. And now the 5 volt is coming in here. The red on this side is connected to positive, this side is connected to the negative. For the motor, you cannot make mistake, so they are connected in here. For the module, I've connected like this. In 1, in 2, in 3, and in 4, I've connected some extension, male to female cable. It is coming, so, and in here, this in 1 is connected to pin 13. And 2 is connected to pin 12. There is one empty between because this is ground. And then N3 is connected to pin 14. And 4 is connected to 27. So they are all in order with the exception that there is a ground. And these pins are labeled exactly as they are here. As you can see here, G13, ground, G12, G14, G27. On this module, exactly the same. G13, ground, G12, 14, 27. You can change it to any other digital pin as you wish. If you need the wiring diagram for this, it is available as part of my Arduino course at udemy.com. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. The original code that I've started is from this example. If you click on File, Examples, and then scroll down until you see this area is for ESP32 and this line is the divider, web server, and then advanced web server. I've taken it and heavily modified it because of some of the enclosure and some functions, so I did not change it. It was making it very easy, but I've heavily changed the code. Now let me explain the code. For the code, you need to set the pins here, pin 1, pin 2, pin 3, and 4. These are for the pins that we have in here, for these input pins. So I've set pin 13, 12, 14, and 27. And then because we want to have 4 push buttons, we have to have 4 angles. This is for 1, 2, 3, and 4. So these are these values that you see here. to 360. And then the next line, we have the direction. And in the next line, we have the direction CW. CW is for 360, CCW is for 270, CW is for 90, and CCW is for 20. And the next line is the speed factor. This is 10 for the 360, 1 is for 270. So they are accordingly aligned. And if you want to have more, just add here comma. And if you want, for example, 187 degrees, you can put it clockwise. Capital CW, do not put small CW, you will get error. And then the speed factor, let's say 2. And then the last one here, this is a value that when you click, it sends the motor, and that is this text. Motor sent to, and also for the last one, also put a comma and inside double quotation. The reason I put all this, because sometimes the location refers to something, and for example, this location, something moves, and you call it 5 degrees, and here you call it turning on or turning off, I don't know, whatever. So in order to allow you to customize it fully, I prepare that. These are the rest. The degree that you see here is this one, N, this IN is here, and then speed factor is this text. I prepare them and allow them to customize it because people are using different languages. For many other languages or for any other purpose, you should be able to change it. And this angle is this text, and then direction, I've not used it here. Comma speed is this text, and then send is this text. So all of these texts that you see here are customizable in here, including this stop. This stop is in here. So anything that you see with the word title, you can customize it. SSID and your Wi-Fi password. This is a router that I'm using for tutorial. I will turn it off, so I don't worry if you know the password. If you need full explanation of the code, it is available as part of my Arduino course at udemy.com. And here is the demonstration. The first thing that you need to know is, because inside the code, this is connected to my Wi-Fi router for this tutorial, it's called Robojax. So your computer must be connected to the same. As you can see here, it is connected to Robojax, otherwise it will not work. So that's the first condition. After that, when you upload the code, click on the serial monitor. This now opens, and press this reset push button here. Press that reset push button. Once you press it, it will print the IP address for you. So you can get this IP address, but in majority of networks, you can directly type this Robojax ESP32. So I'm just copying this now by pressing Ctrl C, and I'm going to show you that one as well, that IP address. So I'm going to open a new tab and then Control V and press Enter. So this is coming now from this module, because the module is now acting as a web server, and these have been defined. So the same way on your phone, first try this Robojax ESP32. If not, then this IP address. This IP will vary from network to network. So whatever your ESP32 shows here, this will be your address. And let me also show you that one, that it will work. Let me open a new tab, press paste and enter. And here, through the IP address, we are getting it. And through the Robojax ESP32 also, we can get this. And now here is a demonstration. Currently the motor is stopped. And these are the available values, the four angles with the direction that is set. The speed, I did not want to show the speed here, but once you click it, for example, for 300 and 270, so it goes When I press it, the motor starts rotating and it shows you the angle, it shows you the direction, it shows you the speed factor that you set in the code, and also it shows you the time that it will take to complete with that speed this angle. For example, if I go for 90, so this will go clockwise 90 degrees somewhere in here. But because the speed factor is 4, it will take 4 seconds to complete that portion. And this 20 degrees counterclockwise from here perhaps to here, and it took 2 seconds because the speed factor was 10. And now let's check 360. So this will come back to the same location, and it will take 40 seconds because the speed factor is set to 10. For 360, if you set it to 1, it will take 4 seconds, and 2, 3, 4, and because it is 10, so 10 times 4 is 40, so this will take 40 seconds to complete. And I am showing you also the counter here at the top so you can see it. And when this is running, at any moment you can just click and stop it. So the stop is available all the time. Let's go for 360. And it is running now very slow, but you can stop it at any moment. Doesn't matter. So this way you can move this to any location that you want and stop it. And from that stop, all these angles are valid. For example, this 90 means from this point now it goes to 90. In clockwise direction, it goes here, so it will go 90 degrees in that direction. And now from here, 90 is in here, and all these angles are with respect to the last known location. So this way you can move it and stop it anywhere you want. Also, I've worked a lot on this section as well, and it was very time consuming. So you can set your angle. For example, you can set it at 450 degrees clockwise and a speed factor of 1. Now it goes 450, so 360 plus some extra angle, it goes 450. And I put here C in front of it, so it means custom. It was 450. The angle was, the factor was 1, it will take 5 seconds, so it completed that angle in 5 seconds. And if I do that with 2, it will be 10 seconds, the same angle. Now it's much slower, and it shows here the timing. And here, my phone is now connected to the same Wi-Fi, the Robojax. And here I'm typing the IP address that I've just shown you. Now here is a demonstration with a mobile device. Let's send it to counterclockwise 270 degrees. So it shows exactly the same as a larger display, 90 degrees, and stop it at any moment, 20 degrees. And you can go also in here. Let me insert here 289 degrees clockwise and go. The push button is not showing the text properly here. I have to see why. And now if I go with 360, I've set it to speed factor of 10, so it will take 40 seconds for this to complete. Let's go for it. Now it shows that it is going for 40 seconds. And in here also, the same way, you can set also the speed factor. The 1 means fastest speed, and as you increase this number, the speed will slow down. For example, if I set this to 2 and I go 360 clockwise or maybe counterclockwise, this will take 8 seconds, because 1 means 4 seconds and 2 means 8 seconds. In 8 seconds it will complete. And the calculation also shown there. Thank you for watching. This was how to control the tiny stepper motor with ESP32 over Wi-Fi, either your mobile device or a browser. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe.